We're only on episode 3 of this shit. Oh my god. Alright, we're looking at another top 10 tips from Clint Emerson's book, 100 Deadly Survival Skills. Let's just do it. Number 1, build a room hide. So you want to spy on the building across the street for whatever reason. Let's say it's my house and you want to see if I'm actually working on the next video. You gotta build a little dark room around the window with these black sheets. But then you want to get into the dark room, so obviously you're gonna have to push past an opening in the sheets, and that's gonna cause all the light to spill in. So you need to get more black sheets and put them behind where you want to enter. You should also make sure that you're wearing dark clothes, otherwise, well, obviously. Does this seem feasible? I guess so. I don't really have a lot of experience with this sort of thing, so can't really comment. The guy in the picture seems to be enjoying some sort of warm beverage, so that's nice. Number 2, steal a vehicle. Oh my god, Clint. So the easiest way to do this is to just come into possession of the car keys, or just hijack a car that's already running. Clint also shows us some neat instructions for starting up older models of Hondas without the keys. You need to pull the housing off the steering column, then apparently you can just break the steering lock with brute force. Then if you remove the lock cylinder, you can jam a screwdriver in there and turn it like it would the keys. And hey presto, you are now the proud owner of a 1999 Honda Civic. I'd rather just walk, to be honest. Number 3, operational vehicle prep. This is just another one of those tips where he tells you to carry all this shit you might need in your car. Some interesting things here too, like cutting the speaker wires and door chimes, putting cardboard over the instrument panels to block out the lights. Also disengage the emergency brake release cable to permit easy operation. Seems like that might be a little bit dangerous. As well as overinflating the tires, disengaging the brake lights, stripping out the airbags and replacing them with guns. And the worst of all, leaving your seatbelt unbuckled. Goodness, what would the road safety authorities have to say about that? Number 4, escape and evasion vehicle prep. This is how you prepare your car for a high-speed chase. Somehow none of this is very interesting, except now Clint says you should always wear your seatbelt at all times, so I guess he had a change of heart. Or maybe the two tips aren't contradictory. Maybe always wear your seatbelt, but leave it unbuckled, you know, just kind of like a fashion choice. Not sure how that would help you in a car chase. Maybe it's kind of like a racing stripe for your body and it helps you go faster. Number 5, build a vehicle hide. This is the same as the first one, only this time it's in the back of a car. And warm beverage makes a return. Number 6, steal a plane. Ah, kleptomaniac Clint, back at it again. He makes it seem so easy. He even says the locks are very easy to pick. He shows you how to hotwire it if you can't pick the ignition. Wire left and right magneto and battery together, he says. Then wire starter separately. Touch starter to other wires to start engine. Should probably look this up in greater detail before attempting to do this. I personally would suggest you don't attempt to do this. Number 7, make a water bottle silencer. Starting to think I probably shouldn't be putting instructions for all these things in a video on YouTube. My name is going to come up in some lunatic's internet history after he does something mad.
My bottle silencer!
Anyways, you cut the arse off a plastic bottle and put a hole in the middle. You wrap up wire mesh into a cylinder and fit it into the bottle. Then you fill the bottle with steel wool and tape the bottom back together. Apparently this actually works with relative success, but Clint fails to mention that this is only good for one shot. The whole thing is going to come apart after the first bullet. Number 8, transform an umbrella into a lead pipe. You just put wrenches in an umbrella and tie it all together with zip ties. The picture shows our hero bringing an umbrella to a gunfight and somehow coming out on top, which is bullshit. A melee weapon against a gun is almost always going to be a losing fight, unless somehow you can move your body faster than somebody can pull a trigger, which you can't, unless maybe that person has Parkinson's. I'm gonna put this down to the illustrator using artistic license for dramatic effect. Should also revisit the fact the title of this is Transform an Umbrella into a Lead Pipe. I don't know why he chose the term lead pipe. The umbrella hasn't become a lead pipe. You can just now use it as a weapon. You're not going to do any plumbing with it. Not that you should be using lead pipes for plumbing anyway. There's lead in them. Number 9. Turn a pen into a weapon. You just stab somebody with a steel-barreled pen. That's it. That's the tip. We see some more examples of melee versus gun combat, including a revolutionary new technique where you just duck under the bullet. Hilarious conclusion there at the end as well. Thank you for that, Clint. Number 10. Use a fishing weight as an improvised sap. Weirdly specific, but I'm sure you can just use some similar alternative to the fishing weight. Put it in the middle of the bandana, roll it up into a tube, and then you grab both ends in one hand. And that's all for today. I think this is starting to become the handbook for how to hurt yourself and others. And if I put any more into one video, I'm going to receive a court summons in the post for irresponsible internet use. It wouldn't be inappropriate for me to now ask you to buy my t-shirts, would it? That's all for today.